Mednykh, who talked about hyperbolic knots, links, and polyhedra.
Okay, thank you very much. It's my pleasure to be on so beautiful conference devoted to the rainbow research leader. And in my talk, I will talk about a subject of mathematics, which also is a very important piece of investigation of Professor Mednykh. I think he spent many years doing hyperbolic geometry. Anya Felixson already told us about hyperbolic geometry in her report, and I just continue. In the case of Anya's talk, she wants to talk about two-dimensional hyperbolic geometry. In my talk, I will be concentrating three-dimensional geometry. Okay, let's start. First of all, the subject I want to investigate are just knot, rings, and polyhedra. And the idea is to look on these three subjects from the unique point of view. Namely, first of all, we want to make some geometrical realization of these guys. Usually in hyperbolic space, but sometimes in spherical space, or maybe also in Euclidean space. And after that, I prefer to investigate some geometrical invariants of these objects, such like volume, lenses of some very particular geodesics, and some another invariants. I start probably with some known example, which essentially is due to Thurston, but maybe the first was Sullivan who used this in the interpretation, but also some result in this direction was obtained by mathematicians. We start just with the cube, which is sitting inside of the Euclidean space. This is just unit cube. I want to divide each face of this cube into pieces, half and half. After that, I use special order 2 rotation, which is Euclidean rotation, to identify the halves of these faces. After such identification, just believe, we have the following object. Red lines formed a circle, and also the same true for blue and green line as well. And as a result of identification, the total topological space gives us just three-dimensional sphere. Three-dimensional sphere is just three-dimensional space plus one point on the infinity. Well, I have no special time to explain this, but it's more or less simple things to understand that we have exactly this object. The people who do knot theory usually call it Boromir rings. And you can understand that as a result we have not only topological object, namely barrier ring, but also geometrical object. This is so-called orbifold. The underlying space of this orbifold is three-dimensional sphere. And this sphere is equipped by Euclidean geometry everywhere except this colored lines. Everywhere locally you can draw a very small ball, which exactly is equipped by Euclidean geometry. But along this color components, we have some singular behavior of the Euclidean map. Namely, if we go around left line, total angle around is just pi, not 2 pi, as in usual hyperbolic geometry. So as a result, we have three singular components, which is exactly shown on this picture. As a result, we have a geometrical realization of the Boromir ring in the Euclidean space, in this particular case, like a singular set of some particular orbital. What happens in the case of hyperbolic geometry? Maybe stay one. Let me explain this. First of all, I want to consider dodecahedra. One can easily recognize that from topological point of view, the cube under consideration in dodecahedra is the same. One-to-one combinatorial topological correspondence. But at the same time, the angles for the dodecahedra are different. Before it was angle pi, now some other angles. If this picture is symmetric, we have used just reflection in place, passing through red line, blue line, and green line. And as a result, this dodecahedra is decomposed in 8 copy of the cube. This is so-called Lambert cube. All edges except color 1 are pi over 2. But the color edges usually are a bit smaller or a bit bigger. It depends from geometry in which we want to realize the consideration. Again, after these rotations, as before, we have essentially the same topological object. This is a three-dimensional sphere and also three singular components. But angles along the components now are just lambda, mu, and eta. So if we know geometry in which this dodecahedra can realize, we also know geometry for this realization of Borromean ring. And also, in some sense, if you're interested in volume calculation, it's sufficient to calculate just volume for the Lambert cube. Then the volume for the Borromean ring will be just 8 times more. Okay, first of all, realization problem. In hyperbolic case, the realization problem for convex polyhedra was solved by the former students of Professor Mednykh, Andreev. In this case, the conditions are quite simple. This angle supposed between 0 and pi. Euclidean case was also shown before. In spherical case, we have to use big angles, bigger than pi. And this means that in these three cases, we have exactly three possibilities for geometrical structure, hyperbolic, Euclidean, or spherical ones. Now, I want to calculate volume of this geometrical object. To do this, I introduce the special notion for the Lambert cube, which was shown before. This is just a central angle, so called the central angle of the cube. A long time ago, Schlafly, who was Schwitzman mathematicians, introduced so called Schlafly formula for the differential of volume. K is just curvature of our manifold. It's minus 1 in hyperbolic case, plus 1 in the spherical, and just 0 in the Euclidean case. So to find volume, we have to solve the following system of differential equation. Some specific initial value are also needed to be sure that this solution is unique. So if you are able to solve this system of equation, you are able to find the volume. In principle, this is a quite difficult to solve such a system of equation if we don't know nothing about the geometrical structure of polyhedra. But our polyhedra is quite nice, so we prefer to use geometrical properties of this polyhedra to solve the system of differential equation. Indeed, it was shown in the PhD of Kerkhaas that the angles and lengths of the Lambert cube satisfy so-called tangent equation. Indeed, she never used this equation, but you can find in her PhD this relation as well. Later, together with my former student Dima Dirgunin, we discovered some more relations between angles and lengths of this Lambert cube. We spent 7 years to understand the geometrical meaning of these relations. Indeed, this is just three-dimensional version of so-called Chevas theorem, which gives a necessary and sufficient condition when three lines passing through the vertices of triangle do intersect in one point. But this is three-dimensional version. Indeed, there are three different equations, up to permutation we have something more. And also a very related result was done by in the paper of Hilna, Lazar and Montesinos. Essentially, this is equivalent things in some sense. If we introduce special variables, like tangent of angles, and also introduce t for this quotient, then the equations, these three kind of equations, give us the following algebraic identity. Because of we are in geometrical case, t squared is never equal to minus 1. As a result, t is just some root of the big quadratic equation. If we know this root, we can find everything. For example, if angles alpha, beta, and gamma are given, we can easily find the lengths of the size of our polyhedra. Well, this is a way how to calculate the volume. This is essentially the identity which was shown in the paper of Hilda Lozano and Lozano. I took just log of this special normalization for differentiation and some special coefficients. Then I claim that this number is exactly the volume of our polyhedra. How to prove this? I have to check that partial derivatives with respect to angles are just minus half of length. Well, easy to find derivatives in two states. First derivative by A, which is just tangent of alpha. And then the second derivative, this is just something related with tangent. As a result, we have possibility to calculate this integral explicitly. This is just a tangent of something. But you remember that in the PhD of Ruth Kelly-Hartz, it was tangent theorem, which gave us exactly the equality limit. In the same way, we can show that the partial derivatives with respect to beta and the gamma are exactly the number we have to use. Now we have to check the initial condition for this function. This is not so difficult because when the angles alpha, beta and gamma are going to pi over 2, that is to Euclidean case, the polyhedra collapses to the point and this parameter t is going to the infinity. So this condition follows from the convergence of this integral. But this can be quite easy to check, that this converges on the point of infinity. So all conditions for differential equation are satisfied. So this is exactly the formula for volume. This is complete proof of the volume formula for this particular case. This is volume formula for the Lambert cube. If you want to calculate something for Boromir ring, you have to multiply this by 8 only. This idea is quite common and we want to use this in different situations as well. I want to say something about very simple geometrical situation. This is so-called hop link. Everybody saw the picture. From geometrical point of view, first of all, we can understand maybe this is not so interesting. But if you consider the complement to this link to the sphere, the fundamental group of this link is just a free abelian group of rank 2. Also, it's known that if you consider any finite covering of the complement, it's again homomorphic to the complement of the same name. At the same time, if you put special angle alpha and beta equal to pi, then we have something which can be obtained by factorization of the three-dimensional projective space P3 by action of group Z2. So P3 is twofold covering of sphere, of the three sphere, branch over exactly hop link. So this is geometrical object when at least alpha and beta are going to P. Indeed, this is true in more general statement. And to show this, we want to realize kind of tetrahedra in spherical space. In this case, the angle of tetrahedra are alpha and beta, which are shown on this picture. All other angles are just pi over 2. Not so difficult to prove the existence of such a guy. After identification producing by rotation alpha and beta, we have exactly more of the hopefully with angle alpha and beta. So this is just a geometrical realization of this particular thing. Now something about volume, maybe not too much about this, because again we use the Schlafly formula to calculate this volume. As a result, we have the following theory. Spherical volume of hop link with con angles alpha and beta is equal to just alpha beta over 2. Probably I avoid detail of the proof, this is just very technical. But it's essentially based on the Schlafly formula, which was mentioned before. Another link, which is also well known in topology, is the so-called trefoil link. Usually, people who do in geometry try to avoid this, because by Thurston's theorem, the complement of this limb does not admit hyperbolic structure. But at the same time, there are many geometrical structures on this limb. Indeed, if we return back to the old paper of the Zeifer and Weber, we can understand the so-called Poincaré homological sphere is a cyclic five-fold covering of a three-dimensional sphere branches exactly of this ring. So geometrical structure of this ring was known a long time ago. Also, some more partial results were obtained by another authors, they are mentioned in my list. And in particular, it was proved for small angles, pi to pi over n, where n is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is just spherical geometry, exactly this situation. You can find the proof in the PhD of William Dunbar, who was a student of Churchill. For n equal to 6, this link can be realized in the more exotic geometry. It's one of the eight Churchill geometries. This is neat one. And for bigger n, we have to use another geometry to make a geometric realization. It's quite surprising, but if we consider not complement for the trefoil, this node complement admits two different geometrical structures, namely this one and this one. This is quite surprising, but it was proved by Rubin in this node. Okay, now what about volume? First of all, I will concentrate only on spherical geometry. The statement is the following. If angle alpha is between these two numbers, then the node admits spherical structure, and the volume of correspondent chord manifold is given by the following simple formula. Just quadratic polynomial in terms of angles. To prove this, we want to use a special model for three-dimensional sphere. We want to use just Hermitian metric, a bit strange form, to realize just standard three-dimensional sphere of the constant curvature plus one. Quite strange, but this lambda depends from the angle under consideration. If we do this, we can find a very nice realization for the fundamental set of this guide. This is just a very special four-enter. This is just curvilinear faces for this four-enter. This is the vertices. But coordinate of vertices in the two-dimensional spherical, two-dimensional complex space are given in a very explicit way. This is just one coordinate number, this is another one, and so on. So as a result, we are able to calculate the lengths of singular geodesics. They are given exactly by these two diagonals. These two diagonals jointly form a trefoil. If we calculate these lengths, we have to show that the differential of volume by Schlafly formula is exactly this number. After the integration, we have the result. So the most important thing was a good geometrical realization for the fundamental set in such a way that coordinates are given in a very, very explicit way. Okay. The same idea can be used also to investigate so-called toric knots and links. They are shown on this picture. This is joint result with Sasha Kolpakov. And as a result, using more or less the same argument, we show that in particular cases when alpha is between these two numbers, the cone manifold admits a spherical structure. And the volume of the spherical structure is given by the formula. This is just generalization of the previous result. The existence of spherical metric in theorem 3 usually was indicated in the case of T. Okay, this is the case when instead of one component for the link, we have two. In this case, the condition for the angle are the formula. Again, if you want to calculate the volume, you have this quadratic polynomial in terms of angles less than beta. Well, one more knot which is well known in the geometry, this is called figure. Probably I avoid this story, it's quite long, but I just want to mention the names of Kim and Mednykh, which indeed very carefully investigates the geometrical structure of this ring. And has proved that it's hyperbolic in some cases, which we want to investigate. Then we have to prove that theory. If angle is between 0 and 2 pi over 3, the conmanifold of the figure 8 knot admits hyperbolic structure. If angle is exactly 2 pi over 3, this is Euclidean structure. And if it's quite big in these two limits, then it admits spherical structure. More exotic geometries on this ring were investigated by many authors. Now, what about volume? We want to calculate volume exactly in three cases. If we are doing in the hyperbolic geometry, the volume of the figure 8 knot is given by the following simple equation. In the case of Euclidean geometry, the situation is a bit more delicate. We have to introduce the length because we need a scale. If L is length of this figure 8 knot, then the volume is just length cubed times this very interesting function. In hyperbolic case, again, we have to use integration. For small angles, this is just more or less the same. If angle is quite big, we have to use another analytical branch of the same analytical function. I just prefer to use this notation. Essentially, it's the same, but another branch of the apostrophe is needed to calculate volume in this particular case. Okay, so this is geometry of the figure 8 knot, and one more knot which is very simple, to the, very close to the figure 8 knot, this is the 5-tool, it's shown on this picture. Again, it was appeared some time ago, when the hyperbolic geometry for this knot just was in the initial stage, best constructed a few copies of the Coxeter group from the following scheme. And as a result, he constructed orbifold, whose underlying space is three-dimensional sphere, and whose singular set exactly this guy, this angle 2 pi over 5. He never mentioned about this. Later it became more or less evident that he did construct this over again. Later Riley discovered existence of hyperbolic structure on the complement of this knot. It was before Thurston. And after that, Thurston proved very, very general theory, which gave us existence of hyperbolic structure of many links and knots. Okay, probably I avoid this also. This is just history, maybe it's interesting, but it takes time to say something to both. What about volume and hyperbolic structure of this ring? Hyperbolic structure of this ring is up to alpha zero, where alpha zero is just root of the following algebraic equation. This is just the value of this guy. And if you know that knot is hyperbolic, we also are able to find the volume of this knot. The volume is given by the following complex integral. It's quite simple integral. Everything is done in a very evident way. Z and Z bar are just complex conjugate root of the following equation. Indeed, this is the order 4 equation. One root is just plus minus 1, we can avoid. Then one more real root, and exactly two complex conjugated roots are in consideration. So everything is uniquely defined by this algebraic equation. It's quite surprising, but formula is very simple. But of course, the behavior of this link sometimes is unpredictable. For example, the complement of this guy is decomposed into three tetrahedra of the same size. Slightly different approach to calculate volume was done in our joint paper with Han and Volodya Petrov. So still, very surprised why so simple formula can be obtained for a bit complicated geometric problem. The same situation can be also understandable for the so-called white height link. It consists of two components, each indicator of alpha and beta. It's symmetric indeed. You can interchange these two components. Again, if we want just calculate the volume of this link, it's given again by complex integral. Here, z and z bar again are complex conjugated root of the following order equation. This equation has two real roots and two complex conjugated, which exactly used as a limit of this integration. Okay, the spherical structure probably can be interpreted in a similar way and have more or less the same formula, but the statement is still not written carefully. The Euclidean volume and the existence of Euclidean structure was investigated in the PhD of my former students, Ruslan Markov. Okay, now one more so-called twist link, very similar to the previous one, but a bit more complicated. Again, we have quite simple formula for the volume of this guy. This is joint paper with Dima Derunin and Mikhail Mulazani. The equations now has power, the order of equation is again 4, not 2 meters. And we have to calculate the volume if you know the root of this algebraic equation. Well, all knots and links under consideration before, except the Borromean rings, also call it two bridge links. So they admit two generating fundamental group. This link is three bridge, so its fundamental group is indeed three generating. In spite of this, we are able to produce more or less the same kind of formula to find volumes of this guy as well. In this case, we avoid polynomial, we have square roots, but essentially the same kind of formula are respectable for hyperbolic volume of this guy. Again, z and z bar are complex conjugated roots of the equations when integrand is equal to zero. This means that this six in the parentheses is equal to one. Some algebraic equation, not so complicated, but of course much more complicated than it was before. Okay, and now something more about trigonometry. I already told you that the calculation of volume in many cases are essentially based on some trigonometrical relation between angles and lengths. If you consider this two-component link and this angle alpha and beta, and lengths of the first are L alpha and L beta respectively, then the lengths and angles of this guy are related by the following beautiful sine theorem. I discovered this many years ago by means of computer calculations, but my student Dimas Peredenko not only proved this formula, he also found explicitly the value of this quotient. It can be expressed in terms of Chebyshev polynomial in very explicit way, but unfortunately it's quite big, but very explicit. So in this case, of course, we also may try to use this identity to calculate the volumes. As a result, one of the possible volume formula is given by the forward integral. In this case, L and M are just tangent of, how to say, sum divided by 4, the difference divided by 4. And T, just additional parameter, which comes from the this algebraic equation. Okay, we have all the four algebraic equations, and it has only one positive root, which exactly will be the limit of integration for this whole form. Okay, now something about spherical Euclidean geometry. Euclidean case is essentially more difficult. And the existence of, core manifold of this guy admitting Euclidean structure in the following relationship between end of the sequence. Again, we have a sinus rule in the Euclidean geometry, and volume can be calculated by the following a bit strange formula. This is just lengths of component of these links, and d is just distance between two singular components of the guy. Maybe the people who like elementary geometry know this formula and just show it. If we start with Euclidean tetrahedra and consider skew edges of it, and suppose that lengths of skew edges are L alpha and beta, ID is just distance between skew edges of tetrahedra. Theta is angle between them. Then the volume, Euclidean volume of tetrahedra is given by the following Serrois theorem. It's quite similar to the result obtained for the link.
And what is L alpha or L beta?
In this case, this is just lenses of skew edges of tetrahedra. Theta is angle between, and d is distance between. But in more general situation, we have essentially the same result up to some special coefficient, which of course depends from the combinatorial structure. The proofs are a bit complicated. We use computer calculation with algebraic numbers. We realize the fundamental set in the Euclidean space, and all coordinates are just root of some quite big algebraic equation. So this is not numerical calculation, this of course calculation is formula, but sooner or later we have the result to show. Okay.